Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, we'll be doing this Photoshop architecture blue line effect here from an actual photograph. Now, if you enjoy this video, make sure that you click the like button and also subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn a lot more about how to use Photoshop, look for my complete training on Photoshop, and you'll find links for that in the description. Okay, let's get to it. To do the Photoshop architecture blue line effect, we'll be starting with this photograph. And the first thing I want to do, and I always do this whenever I'm doing anything which might damage the original picture, is I'll take my background layer and just drag it down to the new layer button. There we go. And make a copy of that. I can then hide my original, so in case I mess anything up, I can always go back to my original and it's saved right here in the file. Real good safety practice. Now, let's take a look at our photograph. It's a nice straight-on picture, has nice contrast in here, nice bright sky, a few things that I'm looking for. But if you notice, the building has a little bit of a keystoning effect in here. In other words, it's kind of tapering in at the top here and tapering in towards the top over here on the right-hand side. We can fix that easily with the Transform tool under Camera Raw Filter. So go up here to Filter, and then come down to Camera Raw Filter right here. Now, I'm working in Photoshop CC 2017. If you're working in an earlier version of Photoshop, you may not see this particular tool. I'll show you where you can find it though. Click on Camera Raw Filter, bring this up, and we'll be using the tool. It's right over here, the Transform tool, right there. Now, before you'd find a link right over here, Lens Corrections, right there. But the one that we want has been moved over here to the Transform tool. As you can see here, a little note, and that's right there. So I'll click on the Transform tool, open this up. Real easy to do. Let me just get this to fit a little bit better in here. There we are, a little better fit. Just go right here to this option. This is a vertical adjustment, and it's going to fix vertical perspective. Now, it needs to be able to see vertical perspective in here. And we have nice solid edges here, easy to pick this out, so there's no problem for the program to do that. So let's click on this, thinks about it for a minute, and it adjusts and straightens the picture up. Now our sides are nice and square with our picture frame, so that's all taken care of. Choose OK. There it is. So you can look at this, there's a difference. Here's our first, and that's our original image, of course, and here's our adjusted image. So original and adjusted. Nice little cleanup on that. Okay, now let's begin working on putting in the blue line. Now I'm going to be using a technique that I've demonstrated previously in my videos, one that I used for taking a portrait and making it look like it was a pencil sketch instead of a photograph. I'm using the same basic technique here with a few little twists on that to improve the effect for the blue line. Take the layer, or a nice fixed layer here, drag it down to the new layer button. You'll say copy. On the copied layer here, our second copy, we're going to convert this to black and white. So up here to image, down to adjustments, and black and white. There's a default look, and it's not really what I want. What you want to have is a good contrast in here. We're really looking for contrast, and the brighter the sky is, the better off this will work as well. So you can just go through and look at the different options. Like blue filter is pretty nice. Nice bright sky, nice contrast in here. Darker, no good. The sky is black. Green filter, even worse. High contrast blue, pretty good, but the bushes down here in the grass kind of block up, so that's no good. Just a matter of going down through and choosing the right one. Now, the one that I used for this particular picture is neutral density, but I will still, every time I do this, I'll still go through and check everything else just in case, depending upon the values in the picture, one of these other ones works out better. In this case, for this photo though, neutral density works out just fine. Nice bright sky, pretty good contrast throughout, so that's good. Choose OK. Okay, there's our black and white image. Now, let's copy this image, drag this down here to the new layer button again, another copy. You can hide that color copy down below. We're just getting rid of things we're no longer using. So we convert it to black and white. Let's now do an invert here on this layer. So we have one black and white and one white and black, just a negative version of this. So I'll go up here again to Image and Adjustments and come down to Invert, and there we are. So we have our positive image and a negative image. Now if we blend these two together in a special way, we can make it look like it's a pencil sketch. And what you want here is the blend mode. Again, we're on the negative version right there. Blend mode and come down to color dodge. And what you see is this white field in here. So it's blending the black and white onto the white and black, and you're just seeing white. Now to give this a pencil look, you need to offset this a bit. You need to do a little shift in here on this one to offset this. And there are two ways of doing that. One is the Gaussian blur filter, so it's filter and blur and Gaussian blur, and a little bit of Gaussian blur gives you kind of a pencil sketch effect. This is one way to do this. The Gaussian blur works out very nicely, by the way, if you're doing a portrait and you want to have a portrait drawn effect. This works out well. It looks kind of like a portrait sketch. The other way to do this is filter and come down to other and down to minimum. And that gives you a little offset. This works out better for this kind of hard drawing. Now I have my radius set at 5. If I go down to 0, there's one radius, real thin. And the higher up it is, the thicker the lines become. It's a personal preference on where you want this. I'm using 5 for this video because it's a lot heavier and easier to see. I probably would use this a little bit less, maybe a 4 or a 3. To do it just for myself, I go back a little bit on this, but I'm doing 5 just so it's really obvious, again, for this particular video. But real low number, in other words, and that gives you that kind of an offset. And that's what gives you that nice pencil-drawn effect, or pen-drawn effect, is that blending of these two together and then offsetting the one layer with that minimum filter. We now need to get this onto a single combined layer. So I'm going to be using a special keyboard shortcut. It's Control Shift Alt plus the E key. And what that does is it combines your layers onto a new layer. It combines just the visible layers, as you can see here, onto a new layer. We can now hide those two layers. We're done with that. And we're now on just this single layer up here. Okay, so far so good. Now let's work on giving this a little bit of an increased contrast in here. So I'll do an adjustment layer at this point. Go up here to layer and come down to adjustment layer and levels. Choose OK. And with this you can boost your blacks a bit in here. And the white's OK, it doesn't need any boosting. So boost the blacks a bit. Just kind of increase the contrast a little bit in here. You can adjust the center value a little bit to the left and boost your blacks. What I'm doing is I'm just kind of boosting the contrast of the lines in here, making the lines darker. That looks pretty good, so I boosted the blacks up to about 63. I brought the whites over. The center point is 1, so brought over to 1.4. That's moving to the left a little bit. And that just helps to increase those values in there, and it increases the contrast, which will help us on our next step. And that's to put blue onto this thing. So for our blue layer, let's make a new layer. Click on the new layer button. There we are. And we're going to be filling this with a blue using the paint bucket. Let's go here to our colors. And you want kind of a nice medium dark blue in here somewhere is pretty good. Now the numbers that I used on this one is 0134 B8, right there, 0134B8. Now it's completely to the right hand side. This is your full value, full saturation on the right hand side, and it's down just a little bit towards the dark. It's down about a quarter of the way down. So anything around in here should be just fine for this, and choose OK. There we are. Then all you need to do is just to fill this paint bucket, click in here and fill that with that blue. Let's now blend this blue into our layer. We want to blend this into the black part of our image and not the white part. To do that, we want the screen mode right here. So blend, little blend modes right there, and come down to screen. And that puts the blue into the dark part of your image. And there's your blue line. Okay, now we're not finished yet. At this point, I mean, there are other videos that you may have seen where they're doing similar techniques and they put in a paper texture on this. I'm not going to be doing that because when I was actually taking drafting, learning how to do actual drafting with pencil and paper and the whole bit, the one thing that was drilled into us was keep your picture clean. So for me, no texture is what I want. It looks okay down here, but I don't want to have anything in the sky up here. So we're going to clean up the sky a little bit. We'll do that back on our layer one. And all we need to do is just paint white over anything in here. So I'll just reverse our colors to white, grab our paintbrush. There we go. Let's zoom in and let's take a look around and see if there's any problems. You can hold the space bar down if you want to move things around. Okay, I'm seeing a little bit of stuff up here. So let's just quickly paint that out just like that. Hold the space bar down, move it over, and just use the white brush to clean this out. Now this is a pretty large brush and I have it set on a real hard, 100% hard setting. And again, just the space bar to make that move. I'm not that concerned about the edges in here. I think those are fine. We'll tighten that up a little bit as we go, but for this picture, that's okay. But this stuff here, I want to get rid of. Okay, same thing here, space bar, and then just kind of clean the sky out a little bit. There we go. Almost have that fixed. Now if you like having a texture back in here, you can put in a texture and blend that in with your blending modes. But for me, it really is not appropriate for an architectural rendering. The paper really should be clean in this instance. So there we go. Cleaned up sky. Looks good. Okay, let's just do a little bit more stuff. Let's put a border around this. This one's pretty easy to do. I'm going to make a new layer above the image layer here. So here's our new layer. Let's fill this layer with white. We already have white available, so paint bucket and fill it with white. Let's now select the whole layer. Hold the control key down, click on the thumbnail. That selects the whole layer. Go up here to select, and we're going to modify that selection and contract it. And I'll contract by 50 pixels and make sure that apply effect to canvas bounds is selected and choose OK. And that just moves that selection in a bit. In this case, it moved it in by 50 pixels. So this inner part is selected. So at this point, all you have to do is just hit the delete key and that cuts that out. We can then go ahead and deselect. So there's a white border around there. Let's now put a little thin edge on that white border. We can do that with a layer style. So go up here to layer, come down to layer style and stroke. There we are, we're on stroke. Color should be black. If it's not, just click on that and then drag to the bottom left hand corner to make that black, or type in all zeros down below here, six zeros. So black color. Set your size. I have my size at 2 pixels and position is outside. You can see it right there. Now when it's outside, it's actually giving me a line here and a line out there, but that line outside is off the document bounds, so we don't see it. And choose OK. So there's a nice little thin line around that. That's a 2-pixel line. If you want that thicker, just change that dimension. For me, the 2-pixel works out pretty well on this one. Okay, last little thing to do here. Let's just clean our picture up just a little bit more, and we'll apply a sharpening filter onto our layer just to kind of sharpen up all of our edges, make it a little bit more architectural looking. So let's go up here to filter and we'll come down to sharpen, and we're going to come down here to the smart sharpen right there. And I found that the defaults works very nicely. Here it is without, here it is with. It's a little hard to see. You can kind of see it in the roof line and right in here. It shows up pretty well right there. So there's without and there's with. It just tightens up the edges a little bit, makes it a little bit cleaner and sharper. And then choose OK. So that's just the default settings. OK. And once it finishes figuring that one out, there we go. So there's our nice blue line architectural rendering taken from an original photo. So let's just grab our original photo down here, pull this one down to the new layer. I'll drag it clear to the top of the stack. There's the original, and there's our blue line rendering. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.